Hi everyone, Dr. Nance here. Today I'm gonna be reviewing the best scenes from everybody's favorite Grey's Anatomy character, the OG herself, Dr. Miranda Bailey. You love her, I love her, let's get to it, stat.
Hi, I'm Isabel Stevens, but everyone calls me Izzy.
I have 5 rules, memorize them. Rule number 1, don't bother sucking up. I already hate you, that's not gonna change.
So when you're an intern, you live and die by who your chief resident is. They're the ones who set the schedules, they tell who goes into what surgery, so it's understandable that all the interns are really nervous and want to get on Bailey's good side.
Trauma protocol, phone list, pagers. Nurses will page you. You'll answer every page at a run. A run, that's rule number 2. Your first shift.
So I know this show was made almost 20 years ago, and there's been a lot of technological advancements since that time, but it's true even to this day that doctors still use pagers, like old school beepers, to communicate with each other. And a lot of times it's just really efficient, but I still have nightmares of that beeping sound that goes off that haunts me to this day.
Starts now and lasts 48 hours. Your interns, grunts, nobodies, bottom of the surgical food chain. You run labs, write orders, work every second night until you drop, and don't complain.
So they don't allow residents and interns to work 48-hour shifts anymore. When I was a resident, probably the longest shifts I was pulling was about 36 hours straight, and that was exhausting. I would come home feeling like a zombie, pass out in bed, only to wake up the next morning and do it all over again. There are laws in place now that limit the amount of hours that interns and residents can work, and that's for patient safety reasons, to try and limit the amount of medical errors that are made by doctors.
Attendings, hog them, sleep when you can, where you can, which brings me to rule number 3. If I'm sleeping, don't wake me unless your patient is actually dying.
So hospitals put the on-call rooms in the most inconvenient places in the hospital. I honestly don't think I ever made it to the on-call room. If I had 10 minutes to sleep, I would usually just find a table inside a conference room and sleep for like 5 minutes.
Number 4, the dying patient better not be dead when I get there. Not only would you have killed someone, you would have woke me for no good reason. We clear? Yes.
You said 5 rules. That was only 4.
Rule number 5, when I move, you move. Get out of my way!
So in the hospital, things go from 0 to 100 all the time. We never like to say the Q word, it's quiet, because you could be called for a code blue at any time. I love a good awkward elevator scene.
Miranda.
Excuse me.
Well, that's your name, right? It's on your jacket. Oh, fine, I'll just call you Bailey then.
You think you're charming and that talented, neurotic, overly moosed hair sort of way good for you. But if you think I'm gonna stand back and watch while you favor her...
I don't favor her. She's good.
Yeah, she is.
So in medicine, like all other fields, there's favoritism. But what Bailey is trying to do is protect her other interns and let McDreamy know that it's inappropriate to let Meredith scrub into the best cases just because she's sleeping with him.
You know, can I point out that technically, I'm your boss.
You don't scare me. Look, I'm not gonna advertise your extracurricular activities with my intern. However, the next time I see you favoring Meredith Grey in any way, I'll make sure she doesn't see the inside of an OR for a month. Just for the sake of balance.
So I love how Bailey is just keeping McDreamy in check, and she's not afraid to use her chief resident power.
This girl is on fire!
I'm proud of you all. You make me proud. You reflect on me well. Grey, if you think you can keep your clothes on long enough to follow up the labs, I'd appreciate it. Karev, cover the pit.
The pit? I'm off gynae.
Dr. Montgomery Shepherd is out sick. You can cover the pit, or you can tell me whose damn panties are on the bulletin board.
All right. So hospitals can be the site for office romances. Personally, I never understood who had the time for such extracurriculars, but all I know is if the chief resident found a pair of my underwear pinned up on the OR board, I'd die.
Don't even tell me you're doing what I think you're doing.
So the morgue in every hospital is in the basement, and it's like a maze to try and find it. And then when you finally find it, it's absolutely freezing. When I was an intern, we had to do these anatomy dissections, and I actually breathed in a piece of the cadaver. It was so disgusting. I actually had to go to the emergency room because I had been coughing so much for 2 days. But to get back to what Christina and Izzy were doing, an unauthorized autopsy. Now, I know this is for a TV show and it's not meant to be situations that happen in real life, but if that ever happened, you would be fired on the spot.
You're fired.
Not only did you disregard the family's wishes, you broke the law. You could be arrested for assault. Do you like jail? The hospital could be sued. I could lose my license. My job. I like my job. Did you think about any of this before you started cutting open a poor man's body? You know, I could seriously kick both your asses right now. Do you have anything to say?
Look at his heart.
It's huge.
It's over 600 grams, and there's some kind of grainy material in it.
We want to run some tests.
Oh, now you want to run tests.
At this point, what could it hurt?
I hate both of you right now.
So when a patient dies unexpectedly or has an unforeseen complication, it's only natural for the doctors to want to understand why that happened. And in this case, Izzy and Christina discovered that he had a condition called cardiomegaly, or an enlarged heart. And they're concerned that this could be a genetic disease. And so this information could actually help save the life of this patient's family. So that's why they wanted to do the autopsy.
Now, if I could please have everyone clear the room.
Excuse me. I have something more to say about Meredith Grey. Ever since I first met Meredith Grey, I knew she was going to be a thorn in my side. You're worried about her breaking rules? Well, that's not going to stop. She's been doing that since day one. And yes, she broke a law to save a life. She's too good at what she does. She's worked too hard to get to where she is. All that she has survived, it hasn't made her hard. It hasn't made her mean or cold. It hasn't made her not care. It's made her better than anyone in this room. Well, except me. I'm Dr. Miranda Bailey, Chief of Surgery at Grace Sloan Memorial Hospital. And I approve this message.
So when doctors do really bad infractions, they can be brought up in front of a medical board like this to determine whether or not their license will be taken away. Now, in this case, we know Meredith Grey is the ultimate rule breaker. But what Bailey was trying to tell the panel is that while Meredith did break a law, she did it in the best interests of the patient. And to see Bailey advocate for Meredith like this as a colleague is just another reason why I love Bailey.
I'm sure Dr. McConnell gave you an excellent presentation. Scissor, watch that tissue. She would be excellent for the job, but that's not the point.
So when you're operating, you have to do a lot of multitasking. You may be teaching a resident, you may be helping a medical student understand a concept, you may be talking to the nurses that are coming in and out who are getting you different tools and materials for the surgery. So carrying on a conversation while operating is normal. However, giving a speech in front of the entire hospital board as to why you deserve to be the chief of surgery, that's just next level only Bailey can handle.
The point is, McConnell and I offer different things. She likes a good challenge. I know, I spent the whole day with her. And that's what this place is to her, her newest challenge. See, I don't care if this place is the shiniest or the fanciest or if it's a beat up hunk of junk. This is not a stepping stone for me. I believe in this hospital. And then I'll do more because this is my challenge.
This bleed on the faucet.
Yep. Oh, snap.
Clear. Use the argon boom. Avoid CBD. There. This job was made for me. Staples.
So what makes a surgeon brave is their ability to handle complications. So in this case, being able to clamp down on an artery and stop the bleeding is what keeps a surgeon calm and collected, just like Dr. Bailey.
This job belongs to me. Suction. I have earned the first chair suture. And every single one of you already knows it. Ready to close. Well, damn it.
Boom, Bailey for president. That's a wrap on the best of Dr. Bailey. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to watch more Med Entertainment videos. Bye!